Hi everybody, welcome to another episode of Fish Keeping Jamaica. Welcome to my channel. Today I share with you an experience in which I have observed within my 30 gallon aquarium. Now this aquarium was about to be clean, but I spent a couple of minutes just observing. Now after taking out my mollies, my swordtail and my guppies from my 250 gallon tote, I decided to keep them in aquariums indoor for a bit, right? So these are my larger mollies. Now my larger mollies included about 3 or 4 female with about 2 males, and yeah, about 6 or 7 of them I have, right? But the story behind everything, in which really reason why I want to share this with you, is my Sailfin Mollie. My Sailfin Mollie is a male, and as you can see, it is actually chasing every female in the aquarium around to mate with, right? Is getting frustrated because all the females are actually running away from it. Sailfin mollies, right? They are really large, they are very aggressive, and they love to mate. To me, they mate more frequently than normal mollies. Now it's getting very frustrating and can't get any female to actually submit to it, so it is picking on anything that is in its path, including some curry catfish that is at the base of the aquarium. You know, it stays at the base, so each time when it goes after a female and it's unsuccessful, it just charges on the curry catfish. Now the bottle in the aquarium, as I said, this is like a holding aquarium that I use to quarantine, to hold fish. I don't use it for breeding because using power head in an aquarium for breeding is like suicide for the fish, right? So it's more like a, you know, quarantine holding aquarium. Now you notice that there is no mess at the base of the aquarium because the power head have been doing its work, where it collects all the mess and it puts it to the bottle. The bottle have a little tube that comes out at the top that actually sprinkle on the surface of the water very gently, and the mess is held in the bottle by some sponge, right? And this is not a aquarium that is on display, so it's okay as far as aesthetics is concerned to me. Coming back to my molly now my molly fish, my Sailfin Mollie fish, I am gonna try and see if I can get a female, because it is tirelessly trying to find a fish to actually submit to its will. It's chasing all female around the aquarium, and it's moving and it's moving, and no one is really, but still, be fair. Imagine you have a supersized giant male going at a small or average size female. I would be afraid too if I was that female fish, right? Because hey, look at that thing, that thing right below its butt, right? It's, what I call it, its instrument. Right now it's charging at everything. It's very aggressive. It wants to mate, and it's using its high fin so as to attract the female, but the females are not really it nearly hit that curry catfish, right? But that yeah, it's the curry catfish is getting a hit. Yeah man, it's getting a hit. I'm gonna have to move it soon, or else I'm gonna come home to curry catfish that are dead, right? So a fish mouth can actually do several things, one of which is hunting, you know, catching prey, eating, taking in oxygen, and also can be a means of actually defending itself through fight. Thank you very much for watching. I hope that this video was, you know, insightful. Have an awesome day. Bye bye for now. Rally here. Cool.